Around the globe, 6.6 million children died in 2012 before their fifth birthday. Since 1990, at least 216 million children did not reach the age of five. At the current rate of under five mortality reduction, 35 million more children will die between 2015 and 2028. In 2000, governments committed to the Millennium Development Goals, or MDGs, which, among other targets, aim to reduce under five mortality by two-thirds and maternal mortality ratio by three-quarters come 2015. Even with so much progress, there is great indication that the global community may not meet its commitment to the MDGs. And so, 3 years to the deadline, the governments of Ethiopia, India, and the United States convened in a high-level forum which gave birth to A Promise Renewed.
A Promise Renewed is a commitment, a promise to all the world's children to ensure their survival, and especially children under 5 years old. It's a commitment by USAID, by UNICEF, and many governments around the world to really ensure that children under the age of five survive and thrive. A Promise Renewed is a call for action for child survival. It's an urgent call for action for all actors to recommit to child survival, to maternal survival. Despite the fact that we see improving trends in child survival, we still see an increasing trend in preventable causes of child deaths for children under five all around the world.
In the Philippines, there are concrete achievements in terms of reducing under five mortality. Under five mortality has been reduced from 59 per 1,000 live births in 1990 to 30 in 2011. But 30 deaths still means 30 lives lost. What we need to work on is that every child is able to surpass the first five critical years of life.
Siyempre naman, gusto kong maging maayos ang buhay ng mga anak ko. Malusog, nakakapag-aral, nakakapaglaro, yung hindi sila magkakasakit. Pag naaalala ko yung schedule, napapabakunahan ko naman sila. Libre naman dyan sa center eh. Isipin mo naman, mag-isa lang kasi akong kumikilos dito. Sunod-sunod pa yung mga anak ko. Eto nga, nagtitinda-tinda ako dito sa bahay. Eh kung kita lang naman kasi ng asawa ko, hindi kami mabubuhay.
Lima po kaming magkakapatid. Apat po kaming nag-aaral. Yung isa po, hindi pa, 2 years old pa lang. Sakto lang po. Pero po, mahirap din po kapag may nagkakasakit. Bawas ang baon namin pambiling gamot. Yung bunso po namin, akala talaga hindi na maagapan. Pero nagsuka tae po. Pero naagapan naman.
Child survival, first and foremost, entails maternal survival. And this is unfortunately where we have a serious concern. At the rate we are going, it will be very impossible to meet the MDG target on reducing maternal mortality ratio.
Reducing maternal mortality rate is a far-fetched dream for a number of reasons. First, the devolved health services makes health programs varied at the local level. Second, poor health-seeking behavior of mothers who tend to disregard seeking prenatal and postnatal health services. And third, the delay, the implementation of the reproductive health law, which among others should provide information to mothers on birth spacing, a crucial element in ensuring infant and maternal health.
Pagbuntis, minsan nagpapa-check up, minsan hindi. Depende rin naman yun sa budget eh. May kakilala nga ako, sa bahay lang siya nanganganak. Pero kapag may komplikasyon, ayun, tinatakbo na sa ospital. Pagbuntis, kalahati ng buhay mo nasa hukay. Nasubukan ko na rin namang mag-family planning. napahinga ako ng 2 taon kahit papano. Kaso, kailangan tuloy-tuloy yun eh. Eh wala nang makain ng mga anak ko. Paano pa ako bibili ng pills?
Kalusugang pangkalahatan will be our strategy to delivering basic health services, especially to those who need it most. Achieving universal health care, or kalusugang pangkalahatan, is definitely among the top priorities of the Aquino administration, and the Department of Health is trying to do its best to ensure that health services and information, especially for mothers and children, are available to the people.
We need to holistically address all aspects of a child's life and well-being. We need to link poverty, education, nutrition, protection, and other aspects of a child's life. With only months to go for the Millennium Development Goals in 2015, we really need to step up our efforts. UNICEF is committed to working with the government of the Philippines to ensure that Filipino children survive and thrive.
A promise renewed for Kalusugang Pangkalahatan is more than just a promise. It is a commitment to take action to accelerate progress on newborn, child, and maternal survival.
A promise renewed to Kalusugang Pangkalahatan reminds us to cling to this commitment. This is something that we would like to see trickle down to local government units and put premium in delivering health services to mothers and children, most especially to ensure that Filipino mothers and children are protected from preventable deaths and contribute in achieving a better quality of life.
Sa akin po, maging maayos lang ang buhay namin, maging malusog kaming mag-